Bless you, bless you, bless you, bless you. My name is Apostle Peter Daniel from Nigeria. Apostle Peter Daniel from Nigeria, Nigeria, Nigeria. I am calling you, I am talking to you from Akure, Ondo State. By the special grace of God, you are watching me on live, Heaven and Air live program, which we used to do every Monday to Saturday. By 9 a.m. Nigeria time, 9 a.m. Nigeria time to 11 a.m. And we also used to do deliverance hour, the deliverance hour, 9 p.m. Nigeria time to 11 p.m. every day. That one, and also we used to do special service. That special service is always we start the program by Saturday, or we do it on Saturday by 10 a.m. Make sure you are there. It is a blessing. It is a blessing. The program is meant to bless many people. The deliverance one is meant to deliver many people from every attack, from every trials. I pray the Lord God will bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Once again, you are the person speaking right now is Apostle Peter Daniel. Apostle Peter Daniel. Now we want to talk about the tongue, or the word of your mouth, the tongue. The Lord God bless you in Jesus' name. Let's pray. Father, in Jesus' name. Our everlasting God, we give you the glory, honor, power, and majesty for the grace and the privilege you have given to us this morning. We ask you, Father, that you forgive every sin we have committed against you. Every transgression, every iniquity, every trials, Father, forgive us in Jesus' name. We ask you, Father, that you give us the wisdom, the knowledge, and understanding of the full word from your throne in the name of Jesus. Open our heart, open our ear, open our thoughts to speak rightly in the name of Jesus. I ask you, O God, to release your spirit upon us in the name of Jesus. Deliver us from all evil. Deliver us from all evil. Deliver all from all evil. Deliver all from all evil. I ask you, O God, Malase tekia la dosianda pa India to see that those who are hearing me, you open their eyes to see the things of the spirit. Open their ear to hear the speaking of the spirit. Open their thought to think deeply and to have a deep understanding. Lord, speak through me to your people. Thank you, Father, because you are God. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. 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 In Jesus' name. God bless you. 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 It is a great thing to have you on the to be on the program this morning. On the program this morning. Now we want to talk about tongues. We all know that in the Bible, the scriptures say that tongue is a powerful thing, which has the ability to kill and to give life. Tongue is has ability to kill and to give life. Is to give life. By the special grace of God, we want to go a little bit deep on what tongue is all about. Many Christians have eventually end up in hell through the tongues of the word of their mouth, the tongues. When they have used their tongue to do, they have eventually end up in hell. And also, many destiny have been swallowed by the devil because of their tongues, That is why sometimes when you speak, you have to be very careful of what you say, Yeah, tongue. You are talking about tongue here. Tongue. What did the Bible qualify tongue to be? Tongue is one of the things that God uses at the point of as a point of authority in the life of man. Yeah. Donc. 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 What a man seeth is one of the things. Open to the book of James. Open to the book of James. Open to the book of James, chapter 3, verses, starting from verses 2. For in many things we offend all. Hear this very well. If any man offend not in word, the same is a perfect man, and able also to bridle the whole body. Hallelujah. Tongue. 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 He said, if any man is perfect in words, if any man is perfect in words, words, the same as the ability of is the same man is a perfect man and have the ability to control the whole body. It means your heaven lies on your tongue sometimes. Are you here? Are you listening to me? If any man is perfect in tongue, in words, the same man has the ability to control the body. And the person, the Bible said, the person is a perfect person. Since the beginning of, from Genesis to Revelations, I have never seen where God said a man is perfect. For the first time in this chapter, I got to understand where God says a man is perfect. From Genesis to Revelation, you will never see where the Bible said a man is perfect. All it has been saying is that a man is never perfect. A man is never perfect. A man is never perfect. But in this verse now, the Bible said, if a man can control his tongue, he's a perfect man. God. Is that word not a surprise word? Before God can say, you are a perfect man. You are a perfect man, perfect man, perfect man. It means a lot, a lot to you. I got to know that many women, they end up in hell because of the word of their mouth. Many women, they end up in hell. Many women end up in hell because of the word of their mouth. Of their mouth. Of their mouth. Of their mouth. Ah! Of their mouth. The way they talk to their husband. Many marriage has been destroyed because of the word of their mouth. Many marriage has been swallowed by the pit of hell because of the word of the mouth of the husband to the wife, or the word of the wife to the husband. And many children's destiny has been swallowed by the wickedness of this world because of the word of their parent. Many people have put themselves into a serious bondage that they cannot be free because of the word they have said to themselves. Some children will offend their parents. Listen very well, please. And what their parents will say is that, you this bastard. You this bastard. See the way you are behaving. And by the time the child grow up, he will begin to create and begin to develop an attitude of a bastard, whereby he will be putting his father and his mother into shame. The word of your tongue. This tongue is the Bible said, it said, if a man can be perfect in word, Do you know that this tongue can cause a war in the world, and it can cause a peace to reign in the world? Eh? What is there that I offend Sister Tama? When I offend her, I say, Sister, I am sorry. Will she forgive me? She will forgive me. But when I offend her, I said, and so, if I offend you, what will happen? What will she do? She will be angry. A word, a tongue. This tongue is as small as you see it, is powerful. The Bible says, as a Christian, he's not talking to a sinner now. He knows sinners are not his own children. He's talking to a Christian like you and I. That if you can control your tongues, if you are able to breathe through your tongues, if you can able to put your tongue under submission and under control, you will be lucky to be a man that is perfect in the sight of God. There was a man that died a useless die in the Bible. I might not go through that place, but I will tell you. There was a man that died a useless death, a useless and bastard death. He just wasted his life because of tongue. What did he say? He came to David, King David, and said, in the battle, I know your enemy is King Saul. So I and King Saul were in the battle. As the battle was so tough, I took my sword and I slaughtered King Sword and King Saul because of you. And David cried. Meanwhile, King Saul nobody slaughtered him. He killed himself. When he see that all his children have died, so he killed himself. He put his sword down and slip by it and kill himself. He commits suicide. But this man, because he wanted to find favor in the sight of David, King David, because he know King David is also a king, and there is an issue between King Saul and King David. The man lied, believing that King David will try, will bless him with something. And the man lied. And when the man lied, King David cried. The man was surprised when he said that he killed King Saul. The King David cried and cried that he has to turn all his clothes and begin to cry that you kill a man of God. And King David said, hey, fell on him. When King David said, follow me, he meant slaughter him, just pieces him. And the pieces, the man, they killed the man there. Meanwhile, he lied. It's not the one that killed King Saul. Is King Saul that killed himself, but he lied. Tongue. This tongue has put many people into serious trouble. Many people are in prison right now because of the tongue. You have a misunderstanding with your friend, and they say, you, I will show you something today. And I begin to take use hand and say, you will know that I'm somebody. If you live to see tomorrow, say I'm not this and that. Meanwhile, they do not have anything. It just mouth. They don't have anything. They don't intend to do evil. They were just trying to threaten. Meanwhile, the enemy have heard that word. I say, okay, thank you, Jesus. And the enemy used the place that point to strike that girl or that brother, and the brother died. And people were saying, how did he die? He sleep and said, as he sleep, he just wake up and say, and he died. And start with vomiting blood. Don't worry. I know we kill him. I know. I was there yesterday when she, sister Emeka, what's the name of this? She's Igbo woman. Sister Ngozi said that I will show you, do like this. You will not listen to tomorrow. That is the one that killed him. And by the time they get to the police station, a policeman say, who do you suspect? Said,
I don't even suspect. I know the person. Say, eh, who is the person? It's a policeman. I don't suspect. I know the person. I was there. Where is the killer? He was not there. Just because he said something. I was there, sir. He said, how come? Yesterday, he and brother Emeka, they were fighting. Sister Ingosi and brother Emeka were fasting yesterday. And sister Ingosi said that if you live to see tomorrow, I'm not Ingosi. And this morning, brother Emeka just died. Eh? Even though at the year I'm they do some in the night. You not hear anything, you know? But because he has said something, the policeman said, eh? She said so. Hey, sergeant, inspector, oh yeah, go and arrest her. And they arrest her, they take it to the court, and the court said, okay, you are the one that threatened the man's life. You are the one that killed him. He said, sir, I'm sorry. God is my witness. God, he began to take Bible. God is my witness. God, see Bible. See Bible. I don't know anything. See Bible. I know they keep us, yo. But it's too late. Eh? It's too late. He has used a mouth to destroy herself. Tongue. Many people has rot in jail because of what they use their mouth to say. As a Christian, this is a word to you that if you can breathe to, you can put your tongue under a submission, you can put your tongue under a control, you are able to be likely to be called a perfect lady or a perfect man. And the Lord believe you that you will also breathe to your word, your body. If you are a type of person that you quickly say something that is very bad in your mouth, Sumoti, you have talked. Ah, you have said bad thing. Sumoti, you have said bad thing. Sumoti, you have angry. By the time you are angry, you say, please, do talk to me again. Please. The Lord will know that you are not qualified for heaven at all. As a Christian, the Bible says something. Said, if you look at the book of that same James, chapter 1, verses 19. He said, wherefore, my beloved brethren, let every man be swift to hear, slow to speak, slow to wrath. You see that? Slow to speak, slow to wrath. So the Lord did not even want us at all to have the evidence of committing sin. Or doing things that are not good at all and at all. So because of this, the Lord is telling everybody to be very careful of the way how you talk. Let's continue. Verse 3, James chapter 3, now, verse 3. Behold, we put bit in the horse's mouth that they may obey us, and we turn about their whole body. For behold, also the sheep, which though they be so great, behold, also the sheep, which though they be so great, and are driving of a French wind, yet are they turned about with a very small head, without so ever the governor listed. You see that? Even so, the tongue is a little member and boasted greeting. Behold, how great a matter a little fire can do. And the tongue is a fire, a word of iniquity. So is the tongue among our member, that it defiles the whole body and set it on fire the cause of the nation. And it is set on fire of hell. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, the Bible was trying to talk about tongue here. Tongue. If you look at the us, as big as us is, they will always put something like a rope in his mouth. That rope, they are using it to control him. So, also, the tongue of man. The tongue of man is as small as
able. The Lord created it, dear. You are looking at, see this thing? Eh? You see this thing? Gee. Look at it very well. This tongue, it is as small as anything, but it is the most greatest of all part of the body. Because it will even tell you whether you will make heaven or not. And according to what is the Bible, God is going to set your tongue on fire separately if you eventually enter. If anybody end in a fire, he will set that tongue on fire itself. Because that tongue itself is a dangerous member of the body. It is like a poisonous. Do you know that a single word from me can scatter you? Do you know that a single word from me can end heaven and earth? A single word from me. And you say, that pastor, in fact, no. That is how powerful word it is. This tongue can bring people and can chase away people. This tongue can cause a war and can cause peace to reign. This tongue can make a nation be patiently blessed. Now, do you know that when a man is not rich at all, is poor, and his wife and children are suffering, and the wife came to the husband and said, my dear, you know we are suffering now, and you have and there's nothing, you do nothing to eat. Do you know what we are passing through? And the husband said, my dear wife, you know I've not seen work. And he talked patiently and he said, my dear, you know I love you. You know you are the love of my life. You know I cherish you so much. You know I desire to always be with you. And you know that the condition I'm passing through is a serious condition. That is why I am managing myself. Please, my wife, please just be patient with me. Things will be okay. Do you know, no matter how serious, you might be angry. When he said that word, you will just say, the Lord will provide, dear. And you are hungry. But when you come to him and say, dear, it has been 2 days now, no food at all. No this thing at home, no this and that at home. And your husband said, And so, if I don't bring money at home, what will happen to it? What? And you said, dear, it is your responsibility to provide for your home now. I said, and so, if I did not provide, what will you do? What will you do? Do you know that we said, you will kill me today. What family name? For 2 days, I did not eat. And you are too shouting on me. You will kill me today. What family name? Yes, because the way he talk caused you to be angry. It caused you to be angry. But assuming he came, and by the time he came, you were complaining, you were talking seriously and said, you have not provided for any of the children for like 2 days for this and that. And the husband said, my dear, should I prostrate and beg you? I'm sorry. You know that this is not going well now. If it's going well, you know I can do more good. You are my wife. Endure with me. Just a little time. God is going to bless us and change our story. Do you know that you will calm down? I remember there was a time. I am very, very, in fact, I don't have money, both in the bank and at home. The only money I have was around 2,000 naira. And, no, 4,000 naira. And the people came to greet me at home. And I am used to this. If anybody came to greet me at home, I will bless them. I am used to that. So, I will not allow you to go without you being blessed. So by the time they came to greet me at home, and I have only 2,000 naira left, they have 4,000 naira left. So I look at them. My wife was in the power. He was looking at me like this. He knows that this man, hey, Mr. Hepper, my wife was looking at me like this. He was like this.
He knows that I don't have money in the bank. The only money I have is 4,000. And there were about 3 people that came. And I said, okay. So when they wanted to go, I look at the face of my wife. I do as if I did not see her. I now go inside. I went to go and take the whole 4,000. I give 2,000. I give the 2,000. I give the whole money. When I was giving them, my wife was there. When I was giving them, it was like this. She did not talk. I was giving them all the money. I don't have 1 naira. No money at all. And I look at my wife's face. I see that she was sad. She could not talk. And I call my wife. I said, come. Let me see you in the room. And I called her. My wife was. I said, dear, I want you to understand something. That, you see, our God see that you don't have anything at all. You see, as we help now, God knows we need something too. You see, it is good to help people. You see, I begin to tell her, I said, dear, don't worry. It is God that is providing this money. God will provide again. The Bible say, give and it shall be given unto you. As I talk to her, she smiled back. She says, she said, okay, I agree with you. No problem. I believe. As soon as I said, why are you fracking your face? I didn't say that. I just pet her. I talked to her. I know she's a woman. And a woman will always, hey, my wife is gentle, but she was. So I now say, okay, it's all right. Just calm down. God will do it. God will do it. And she calmed down. She laughed. I said, God will provide for us. Do you believe? She said, I believe. Do you believe? She said, I believe. Do you believe? She said, I believe. I said, that's it. And that smile is, she smiled back. She was happy and we both smiled out. We believe. That night, somebody sent 50,000 to me. That same night. The same night I gave my old cash, somebody sent me 50,000. Now, assuming when she was frying her face, I called her and said, yeah, come, let me see you. And I said, why are you frying your face? Why are you frying your face? Am I not the owner of my money? You know that it will cause problems at all. No matter holiness she might be, she will like, daddy, you know you are shitting me in this house. And that's where Satan will start coming. There's no way. You know you are shitting me in this house. What are we going to eat in the night? Are you giving the whole money to the people? It will start argument. But before that, wisdom, life is wisdom. No matter, somebody can be, you can say, my husband is a holy pastor. My wife is a holy sister. It's this and that. If you do not know how to talk, if you do know how to control your tongue well, your home will destroy, your home will break. Holiness does not come to the area of tongue. Yeah, I remember something. When I was small, I didn't know the meaning of that thing. Listen to me very well, everybody. When I was small, I didn't know the meaning of that thing. I used to say to myself, and I don't know the meaning because I was too small. And the moment I was saying it, Jesus Christ used to come to me and visit me that time, physically. I will say it. I said, I will not go to university. University is too corrupt. I don't know. I've never get there before, but that mentality have just been upon my head. I don't know who put it there. I will not go to university. I will not go there. Never in my life. If my mother said that, after you finish your secondary school, you go to university. I would say, go, never for, God forbid. I will not go to university. I was too small. I don't know the meaning of university that time. You know, I don't know the meaning of that thing there. So by the time I now grew up, I now got to know that words of mouth come to pass. By the time I finished my secondary school, I wanted to go into university. The Lord said to me that I should not go. That I should focus on his ministry. I try and pray. I should not go. When I tried and tried, my father was angry with me. There was a time he said, this and that. I just said, okay. I wanted to go. Never. I even enrolled there. I was in the school. The Lord said, I better come out. What am I trying to say? Word of mouth within that things is powerful. Many Christians will eventually end in hell. Little thing will happen to you. We say, yay, my head. Ah, God. See the way I've been serving you since all these days. And you allow this thing to happen to me. Ah! Assuming I'm not a Christian, it will have been better. That statement you make, automatically your name will just come out from the book of life. Paramba. It will just disappear. Paramba. Your name will just disappear. Pram. And God will mark you as unbeliever, not as a child anymore. Words are very difficult. You have to be very careful of what you say. Don't say anything negative from your mouth. Even to yourself. When you do have money, say, I am poor. In fact, do you seem that I'm rich? I'm not rich, I'm poor. Do say that to yourself. Always say to yourself, I am rich. I am rich. Say to yourself, I am rich. I am prospered. I am succeeded. I will succeed in all my way. I am blessed in the morning. I am blessed in the afternoon. I am blessed in the night. Always say it to yourself. Prayers. Never say negative things to yourself. It can destroy yourself. You see the mouth you are talking about. I want us to continue the reading of that thing to be finished. He said, for every beast, verse 7 now, for every beast and every bear and every serpent and everything they see is tamed and has been tamed of mankind, verse 8. But the tongue can no man tame. You cannot bind tongue, never. It is an unruly evil. The Lord qualified tongue as evil. Full of deadly poison. Hey! Your tongue is a deadly poison. It can destroy life. Do you know your single word? Somebody came to you and you say, you think that word is a light word. That person that can, because of that little word, go and commit suicide. Many homes have been scattered now because of the word the wife said to the husband. Your husband loves you with all your heart. With all his heart, he cherishes you, he desires you. In fact, he loves you seriously. He cannot live without you. But one day you say a single word, one word, and that word, it pains him to an extent that he decided in his mind that as from today, he will not show you love again. And he decided that as from today, he will not see you as his wife again. And these are the problem in the life of many Christians. The Bible said your tongue is a deadly poison. Therefore, bless we God, even the Father. Therewith, cause we men, which are made after the similitude of God. Listen to this verse 10 very well. Out of the same mouth proceed blessing and curse. My brethren, this thing ought not to be. Does a fountain send forth at the same place sweet water and bitter? Question mark. Can the fig tree, my brethren, bear olive berries? Either a vine, fig, so can no fountain both ye salt water and fresh. So, you are evil when evil thing came out of your mouth. You ought, instead of you cursing people, why didn't you decide to bless people? Instead of you saying negative things to people, why didn't you decide to say blessing to people? Instead of you saying what things that is going to get other people angry, why don't you say things that will make people happy? Why? Rather, you rather choose to be evil.
rather chose to be evil. And listen to me very well. Out of your mouth come out like a bullet. Your words is like a bullet. Anything you say can make a destruction of man and can make a destruction of you. It can destroy you and it can destroy others. Out of your mouth proceed curse, and out of the same mouth produce blessing. Out of your mouth proceed praise and worship, and out of your mouth you worship the devil. Is it all to be? No, it is not right at all and at all. Try your possible best to make sure that you use your tongue to worship God, as God has created your tongue to worship Him and to say blessing. When people greet you, say blessing to you. When people curse you, say blessing to you. When people pray for you, say blessing to you. When people help you, say blessing to you. When people try to ban, to destroy your life, say blessing to you. Let your mouth and your tongue always bless others. I pray that your tongue will not take you to hell. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. As a Christian, key word for you to remember and remember and remember. The Bible said in that James chapter 3, verses 2, it said, if any man can put under submission your tongue, such a person is a perfect man. And if you are a perfect, it means heaven is sure for you. If you can put it under bondage, your tongue, under law, under rulership, you are careful of what you say with your mouth. You say, when people ask you, you come with a cool voice. You talk a good word with your mouth. You bless yourself every day. You never curse. You never say angry word. Let me tell you, every parent that are saying negative things to their children, you cannot make heaven, never. And the Lord will always punish you because you have not used your tongue in the right way, except you go and repent. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. The person speaking to you is Apostle Peter Daniel. By the special grace of God, God has made me a watchman over his house. I pray the Lord God will bless you, and I pray you will make heaven at last in the name of Jesus Christ. May the blessing of the Lord be with you. Bye-bye. Thank you.